the disease is called epidermolysis bullosa, and it's when your skin doesn't have the protein that keeps the layers of skin together. So any friction, any small amount of trauma or pressure to the skin can cause it to detach one layer of skin from the other. Throughout my wife's pregnancy, there's no sign of anything being wrong. It was all normal. Not only did we not expect this disease, but we didn't know anything about it. Before we left the hospital, about 4 different pediatricians came to see Ethan, but no one had any clue of what it could be. I thought that the blisters on his fingers were just from him sucking on his fingers when he was in the womb. The condition is very painful. There's a lot of suffering involved and a lot of traumatic experiences in these last 2 months. Ethan was diagnosed with Hurtlitz junctional epidermolysis bullosa. For 25 days, we had him at home, and all we knew was that he had sensitive skin, but we didn't know how to avoid making it worse. At first, I thought it was impossible for Ethan to have this disease, because they let us know that it was hereditary. And I thought to myself, we have a large family and a very healthy medical history. The scariest moment of his 2 months of life was on Thanksgiving. Ethan stopped being able to breathe on his own. And his eyes widened, his mouth widened as he gasped for air, and he turned purple. And then he started turning gray as we rushed him out. I looked over to my wife, and she started to cry while she was looking at Ethan. And I told her, you know, I said, this is the time to save Ethan's life. And we have to keep focused on it. Then we were transferred to Kaiser in Santa Clara, and we didn't know if he was gonna survive. Ethan suffers through pain every day.
What did that happen for?
It dried out.
Hmm?
It dried out.
Oh.
the disease is restless. Makes life difficult for him 24 hours a day. Throughout the night, he wakes up constantly choking on phlegm. And when we suction his phlegm out, a lot of times blood is coming out with it. Even skin disease spreads internally, affecting the esophagus and the trachea and the digestive tract. Which seems to be the case because it's very difficult for him to even just pass gas. He cries and does these frantic movements, like kicking about, throwing his hands. It's definitely difficult to watch. Lethan has lost all of his fingernails and toenails, and the skin on there is very raw. And even just touching his fingers make him cry. And we've came to know that Ethan only cries when he's in pain, probably because it is painful for him to cry. So he doesn't cry when he's hungry. He doesn't cry when he needs a diaper change. He doesn't cry when he's uncomfortable. He only cries when he feels large amounts of pain. Which makes it even more difficult to hear his cries. My family and I want to spread awareness of this horrible disease. We ask you to support these EB families. Can't think of anything more difficult than to watch your baby endure such pain and suffering and feeling helpless, knowing that there is no cure for this horrible disease. So we ask you to support these families throughout their hardships, their hard times. Thank you.